Friends, Romans, countrymen, my name is Rhys Dawkins, and I am the most intelligent professional wrestler on this side of the globe. When I heard that William of the Scottish Wrestling Network was performing some kind of birthday bonanza quiz of some description, I knew that were I to participate, I would defeat every single one of you without breaking a sweat. So, in order to allow you to avoid the embarrassment at my victory, I shall instead be hosting a section of this quiz for you. Since I was told that I'm not allowed to do Shakespeare, instead I shall be reading you a paragraph about professional wrestling history. However, there will be an error within that paragraph. If you can correctly identify where the mistake is, that is 1 point. If you are able to also tell me what the correct answer is, that's an additional point. The 10 points in all, 5 questions altogether. So, let's begin, shall we? The Elimination Chamber is a brutal stipulation. Metal chains and grating make it an imposing structure, and many titles have changed hands within it. In 2003, for example, Triple H defended the World Heavyweight Championship against Goldberg, Randy Orton, Kevin Nash, Chris Jericho, and Shawn Michaels. Goldberg tore through the competition and walked away with the gold, allowing Triple H to recover from a groin injury he suffered before the match. The groin injury is true, but Triple H actually retained the championship at this event, losing it to Goldberg a month later at Unforgiven. Not everyone can become a world champion, even in WWE when they can have as many as 3 at a time. Not everyone can hold the most prestigious prize. Though some renowned grapplers like Mr. Perfect, Ricky Steamboat, and Shelton Benjamin have become synonymous with the secondary Intercontinental Championship, with Mr. Perfect in particular holding the current record for the longest individual title reign with the belt. This prestigious honor of the longest single individual title reign of the Intercontinental Championship is not held by Mr. Perfect as of this recording, nor is it held by Ricky Steamboat or Shelton Benjamin. It is held by the Honky Tonk Man at around 454 days. The shortest reign is Dean Douglas with less than a day. Many people dislike the two rivals who can't get along become tag team champions trope, but I find it incredibly entertaining. MVP and Matt Hardy's segments of one-upsmanship, Eddie Guerrero and Tajiri's cultural clash, and Cesaro and Sheamus with the conclusion to their best of seven series all led to very entertaining moments and championship victory. Eddie Guerrero and Tajiri were not rivals who became partners, though they were champions together. Chavo Guerrero was injured during a feud with the world's greatest tag team, and so Tajiri won the belt with Eddie Guerrero as a replacement. In 1996, Rowdy Roddy Piper and WCW heavyweight champion Hulk Hogan battled for the main event of Starrcade. After avoiding the shenanigans of the NWO, dressing them down in promos, and being brutally attacked after hip replacement surgery, Piper wrote up the contract and was able to defeat Hogan with the sleeper hold, a rare submission loss that saw Piper walk away with the WCW championship. Roddy Piper did not win the championship, though he did win the match. Despite writing up the contract himself, it appears the Hot Rod forgot to add that little stipulation. The Grand Slam in wrestling is an honor granted to very few, and is incredibly difficult to gauge as many companies handle them differently. WWE have 2 male variations, with the likes of Shawn Michaels and John Cena as members, as well as a more recent women's variant. TNA had a standard version with holders such as AJ Styles and Samoa Joe, who won the tag team championships by himself. Ring of Honor's 6-man tag team championship was considered and had holders such as Matt Taven. And New Japan's Grand Slam was established in 2021 with the distinction of including only singles championships. John Cena has never held the Intercontinental Championship, and therefore is not considered to be a Grand Slam champion by any of WWE's established metrics. I hope you enjoyed my little segment all about the historical recall of professional wrestling and its championships. If you managed to get some of these correct, congratulations. And if you didn't, I'm not surprised. But the next time Billy has one of these quizzes, be sure to keep in mind the great works of William Shakespeare will grant you the intelligence necessary, potentially, to walk away with the victory. Unless, of course, I happen to be participating. Mark my words.